Sam and I are going to take you through the wall ball shot. Just like the thruster, this is a movement that's dependent on generating momentum with your hip, getting it through your chest into the object that you're trying to drive straight up. I see a lot of people make this move more difficult than it needs to be. First, they'll stand too far away from the wall, having to overcome a horizontal span as well as a vertical one. And second, they won't maintain contact between their body and the ball when they're generating momentum, therefore introducing a spring system, very much like the thruster. And as a matter of fact, if you haven't watched our thruster video yet here on the Mic'd Instructor, I'd go ahead and review that. The principles are going to apply here. But Sam, go ahead and set up on the ball. When she does, of course, she's in a good squat stance. Her weight is on her heels, and we'll notice that she has contact between her chest and the ball. This is going to enable her to drive all that hip power directly through the torso into the ball. Okay, go ahead and give me a few good reps, Sam. Drive into your target. Good, go ahead and relax. We'll see that she's driving her chest through the ball. When she stands up, she's also projecting her hands. One of the mistakes I see people make a lot is they don't follow through with the movement, and so they'll kind of get this half-assed arm extension only to here, and they won't hit their target. You want to be projecting directly into what you're aiming at. For those of you who have played basketball, it's very much like a chest pass. I want you to imagine that you have your hands essentially in this formation and that you're trying to see the target through the L's that you're making. So Sam, when you go up, I want you to really project. I want you to see your target and frame it with those two L's. Go ahead and follow through all the way to extension. Good. We get nice solid contact, a good bounce back. That ball's in contact with her chest, and relax. Okay. So by driving through, we enable that to hit the target at the same speed every time, and we're enabling it to actually hit the target. You wouldn't believe how many people miss because they're in more of an upward than an outward orientation. At the same time, we see people often set up too far back. We'll see them try and give themselves all sorts of room to hit that target. The problem with this, it should be pretty obvious to you, your hip in the up-down configuration is only capable, really, of generating upward velocity. But you're also asking for horizontal velocity, and of course, what makes this? Your arms. They're going to get very fatigued shooting from this angle because we can't depend on the hip. Go ahead and shoot a couple, Sam. We see that she's still got to project at her target, and she's not even under that ball when it comes back unless she really hones on it. And so, you might get a fitness benefit, but you're going to lose it in cycle time. You're going to lose it in the fact that you're not able to catch that ball efficiently. Okay. Sam, go ahead and pick that up. Now, this is a point that we're reiterating from our thruster video. Get closer to the wall. There we are. We want the weight on the heels, and we don't want you to come up on the toes as you drive through. Again, we want momentum to be generated depending on time of contact and area of contact. That foot stays flat, the weight stays in the heel. Go ahead and drive, Sam, and we'll look at that heel. You see it stay down. She projects into the target, and we also see that it's very easy to project into your target. Push into the target. You're pushing too much up. Push in. There you go. Push in. Down up. Push in. Good. Push in. Come on, don't stop. Let's go. And relax. Sam does have trouble with the wall ball, and we're in the process of fixing that. Keeping that heel down is going to be instrumental to you keeping your balance. Now, what you're doing right now, you can hear, see that ball kind of skimming the wall on the way up, is she's not actually hitting her mark. She's worried too much about hitting the wall on the way up, and so she's not projecting at her target. Sam, go ahead and take that back up. Okay. And what I want you to do is basically a straight up thruster with that ball. I don't want you to push it into the wall at all. Go straight down and drive it straight up over your head. Good. Now, I want you to go down, and I want you to drive it into the wall below your target, about here. Good. Now, I want you to find the medium between those two, projecting directly at that spot on the wall. Down, project. There. Beautiful. We get that nice kiss of the ball off the wall and a great rhythm. Last one, relax. Okay, so we lost it on that last one. What we're doing there is a very simple coaching technique. We're helping Sam find the extremes. Obviously, the vertical extreme is straight up. The horizontal extreme is straight in. We want her to find somewhere between that. So if we have an athlete that's pushing too horizontal, make them do that straight up vertical push. If you have somebody who's pushing too vertical, have them do that horizontal push. And they're naturally going to try and meet somewhere in the middle when you ask them to mediate that movement. And we saw, Sam, that when you did that correctly, we got three or four beautiful kisses off the wall. That ball came right back down into your hands where you wanted it. Now, for advanced practitioners, somebody who's really trying to cycle this, say a Karen, 150 Wallball shots for time, your minute in fight gone bad, you're trying to push out 30 of these. When you go and drive up, don't push your hands up, follow through and retract them and then extend them to grab the ball again. I see that a lot. What we want you to do is actually leave the hands out to receive the ball. So go ahead and pick that back up, Sam. Okay, so when you drive, frame your target with your L, hit your target, and leave your hands out until that ball comes right back to you. Beautiful. Exactly what we're looking for. Her weight's on her heels. Get that contact and relax. One other thing you're going to notice, the ball does not do a tremendous rotation. This is not a jump shot. This is a knuckleball. You're taking your hands flat in this position and you are pushing them through the ball. This is not one hand dominating the other. And I see that a lot too. People go to shoot that Wallball, one arm stronger than the other, and so we get rotation on the ball. That rotation is going to make the bounce off the wall unpredictable. It's going to disrupt your rhythm. Sam, all these things that we're talking about, keeping your heels down, framing your target, kissing your target, keeping contact with the chest and keeping that push is all really in the service of one thing, rhythm. When these are done correctly, it's metronomic. It's pop, pop, pop. And so it'll benefit you perhaps to keep a count in your mind, 1, 2, 1, 2. As you're doing these, take your mind off the pain, but also help you realize that this is at its heart something done rhythmically. And all this really is a thruster where you're letting go of the object and letting it come back. So we need practice there. And what we're gonna do is I want you to take 5 perfect shots. Rather than try and do 100 in a row and let them get increasingly sloppy, burn in the perfect motor pattern. Burn in keeping those heels down, that chest up, hitting that target and kissing it. Sam, let's leave them with 5 good ones, okay? So keep that weight back, frame your target. Good. See that light kiss on the wall? Push, there you go. Good. We had a little bit of rotation, got a little sloppy, but we keep practicing, making it perfect, and eventually those 150 Wallballs aren't gonna hurt you at all. Good job.